We asked Ian Anderson of Jethro Tull if he'd ever work with longtime lead guitarist Martin Barre again. I'm John Beaudin from Rock History Music. Martin Barre joined Jethro Tull on their second album in 1968 called Stand Up, and he was there till 2012. And a lot of fans, especially after the 50th anniversary, thought at least Martin Barre would come back into the fold. But in rock and roll, it's never that easy. What fans want or what they think is going to happen is not always what's on the plate. Everyone thinks that there's a lot of kumbaya moments between band members throughout the years, but sometimes the longer they've been together, the more reason there are to maybe not be together anymore. And Martin Barre is also on the road doing his own Jethro Tull thing. I asked Ian Anderson if there was ever a chance that he would work with Martin Barre again.
Well, I've thought about asking Martin to come along and do something, but then when I look at his date sheet, I realize he's already committed to doing things somewhere else. So, I mean, it's not impossible, but if the question was really more, would I be comfortable having Martin as a full-time member of the band in 2020, then my answer would be no. And I know Martin Barre's answer would be no, because, you know, he has found, certainly not without prompting from me, because 20 years ago I kept telling him, Martin, you should get out there and do your things with the Jethro Tull repertoire and not just be the guitar player in the band. And I've always encouraged him to do that. And it took a long time before he really started to take it seriously. And of course, in the last year particularly, he's now found enough representation through agents and promoters to be able to do proper tours on his own. And, you know, I think he's really enjoying what he does. And it would be a bit of a negative step, I think, for him to go back to being the guitar player in a band that I, you know, kind of control, manage, operate, write the music for. And, you know, he wouldn't be comfortable, I think, with the culture of the band in the last 10, 15 years, because we do things, you know, in quite a different way to how they were 30 or 40 years ago. And in the day of, you know, since the internet became a tool of our trades, from the point of view of travel, planning, arrangements of music, I mean, everything is completely different now to how it was during the period when Martin was in the band. And Martin, one of the issues that was, unfortunately, you could laugh about it, I suppose, but Martin never took to the internet, never took to emails and using computers in terms of music or technology. It just didn't, he didn't find it, perhaps he didn't find it easy, he certainly didn't find it desirable. I mean, that may well have changed now, but certainly if we go back to, the first decade of the new millennium, Martin did seem, you know, rather resistant to those kind of changes. And so it could be quite infuriating trying to communicate, because everybody else communicated sometimes several times a day by email, by internet, by sending files. And Martin just, you know, you never knew whether he read his emails or not, or whether he opened a file, you know, a music file or an itinerary or whatever it might be. And so it became quite frustrating. But that's you can laugh and joke about that now, because it's not really that much of a serious issue. But it would make it very difficult to operate today, when the guys get, they access in the cloud a number of folders and files that allow them to check itineraries. Even going well into 2020, they will find itineraries in the making. They're not all complete, but, you know, they don't have the booking references because I haven't actually booked the flights yet. And they may be missing some hotel information, but they will have all the main ingredients, like when we fly out, what time we're intending to fly, on what airline, and you know, they'll find the set lists, and they'll find all the music references for songs, new songs in 2020. They have to prepare and learn. You know, they will. It's all there for the band and the crew to access and utilize, and so. That's the way we work these days. Mm-hmm. You know, it's a very extensive use of communications, be it, simple emails or text messages or, you know, managing folders and dealing with music and photographic files that are perhaps quite specialist programs. And, you know, that's the world we live in now. And I think it would be pretty difficult having somebody in the band who didn't work that way. we don't print out itineraries any longer. Yeah. You know, we don't hand out tickets. People go online, find out where we're going from, check their booking reference, log into the airline, print out their boarding passes. You know, they kind of do that stuff for themselves, and we meet each other on the plane or in the departure lounge. We don't need tour managers. They're an extinct breed that we haven't employed directly a tour manager for, I think it must be now 15 years, 16 years. Well, maybe longer than that.
Wow.
It seems like maybe 20 years since we employed a tour manager. It ceased to be of any use to us whatsoever somewhere around the late 90s.
This is part one of our second interview with the great Ian Anderson. As you've seen throughout the video, there's a brand new book which features all the past members talking about every single one of their albums, all the big ones. Lots of quotes, lots of newspaper clippings. I got an early copy of it, and it's amazing for any Jethro Tull fan. Also, the 40th anniversary Stephen Wilson rejigged Stormwatch is out. It's a big package. We'll have links to the Jethro Tull site, which, by the way, is the only place you can buy the book, for instance. And we'll have more from Ian Anderson of Jethro Tull in a few days. He talks about all the big albums on this interview. It's nice that we had him on film this time. And we talked for 47 minutes, so there's lots of Ian Anderson coming up. Make sure you comment on our video, subscribe to our channel, and share our videos. I'm John Beaudin. This is Rocky Street Music.